you know, first of all, you said at one point, or you have been asked, you know, what would you do as president? And you said, first of all, I'd have a bipartisan cabinet. Secondly, you would seek out the middle. Thirdly, you would try to create new rules that would lead to a common prosperity. What do you mean by that?
Well, you have to benefit the majority of the people, and you have to draw on the best people possible.
Is that not happening now?
It's narrowing. Just by any of the measures, since 1980, per capita income for the bottom 60% of the population has not risen. If you ask surveys of...
And is that a failure of capitalism?
It's a failure... Every system needs to be improved and modified and made better, right? So, and I'm a mechanic, so I just look at the cause-effect relationship. It is because there is an element in which the reinvestment of gains do not go down to create the basics. What are the basics? Yeah, here's all you need. Parents who will take good care of you. A good public education system, and equal opportunity. That's all you need. That's all it has existed throughout history. You give those things to people, and by and large, you have a much more prosperous, you can draw the talent from wherever it is. So those are the things. And we're in a spiral, because also the children who grow up in some of these areas from childhood, and they're... they don't have the parents, they don't have the circumstances in terms of the basic equal education and so on. And that population is a growing population. And so we see then the disenfranchised, the opiate addiction and other issues that we're having, mental health, other issues is because that population. So let's just go back. How did Donald Trump get elected as president? There was a population that was a disenfranchised population that wanted somebody who was going to fight for him, like populists do.